สวัสดีครับ Greetings from Bangkok Once again กสิทธิ์ พิรมยา We are now approaching the end of the month of June 2024 But looking back over the past 12 months or so, one of the most important news in the Indo-Pacific area is about the achievements and progress of Vietnam, not only in terms of economic development, but also in terms of the foreign policy positioning that Vietnam has been able to gain a lot of attention, not only from the political aspect, but also from the business and investment aspect. Or in other words, Vietnam has become the darling of the international community. I think surpassing Thailand, which was or has been quite prominent in the eyes of the international community for many decades. But it seems that Thailand has, by default or unintentionally, default its prominent position. Why? This is something that we could discuss. But let me give one observation that during the past 12 months, Vietnam had welcomed three very prominent world leaders, namely President Biden of the United States, President Xi Jinping of China, and latest, President Vladimir Putin of the Russian Federation. So, the most important world leaders have traveled to Hanoi, the capital of Vietnam. What has Vietnam done to have been able to attract such attention of the great world leaders? I think it's the political stability in Vietnam is one factor. Second, the sense of direction of where Vietnam would like to go in terms of socio-political and socio-economic direction. I think there is a sort of a set of clear-cut directions that the international community and the big powers in particular do understand and would like to be associated with Vietnam. And the Vietnamese leadership in the positioning of Vietnam in the happenings of the Indo-Pacific region and in the international arena in general, I think the Vietnamese leadership has been able to utilize factors of history to its utmost advantage. For example, Vietnam has been able to retain close and cordial relationship at the party level namely between the Vietnamese Communist Party and the Chinese Communist Party. The party-to-party relationship is one of the pillars of the relationship between Vietnam and China. In spite of the fact that there have been many incidents, controversies, conflicts, and differences between the two countries. And the latest is the dispute over the overlapping claims in the South China Sea, and a sort of assertive and bullying tactics undertaken by the Chinese government in terms of military installation in the islands and islets in the South China Sea, in a sense threatening the very security of Vietnam and also to other claimant states such as Malaysia and the Philippines and Brunei and so on. But Vietnam has been able to keep the party-to-party relationship at a position where constraint could be made, and at the same time to look for the possibilities of enhancing the economic relationship, trade, investment, and so on. So Vietnam has been able to play its Chinese card quite well. At the same time, Vietnam has been able to enhance the bilateral relationship with the United States. Again, playing on the historical card, the fact that the United States during the Cold War was the opponents of communist Vietnam. The Vietnam's communists were able to defeat the armored forces of the United States. So there are so many grievances and so on. But both sides have been able to overcome that. And I think the United States government and the society in general would like to amend the past grievances and so on by opening up the American market, promoting business activities in Vietnam, foreign investment, and so on, or even to help to a certain extent the beefing up of the military hardware of Vietnam. So Vietnam has been able to use the history to its advantage in the reconciliating and renewal of friendship and cooperation with the United States. And at the same time, Vietnam is fully aware of the fact that it is a frontline state from the point of view of the United States in containing the expansion of China. So Vietnam is playing its card in a very cautious but astute manner of cooperating more and more with the United States when it comes to the question of the containment of China. At the same time, Vietnam has used the historical relationship between Vietnam and the then Soviet Union, which inside the Soviet Union, Russia was the main entity. And the fact that a few days ago, President Vladimir Putin came to Hanoi, in spite of the changes inside Russia, no longer a communist state, but the historical relationship of the past paid has played a very important role in the renewal and the enhancement of the bilateral relations, both in terms of trade, investment, energy, and new technologies and military cooperation. And in all of this, because the Vietnamese leadership knows its own history and has used historical facts and factors to the best of its ability for its own interest. And it has been able to do this because of the political stability inside the country, as well as the preparation of the manpower to cater to the incoming foreign investment from all directions. At the same time, the Vietnamese leadership places the interests of the country before anything else. No more factional politics that might create domestic instability and so on. And it has put its house in order when it comes to governance, in combating very seriously all the corruption practices inside the Vietnamese administration and in the business circle. So it gives somewhat of the confidence and respect to the international community. It gets the receive the confidence and respect from the international community. And comparing to the situation in Thailand, there has not been for so a long time now political stability. There are still divisions and confrontation in the Thai political arena. And political parties and political leaders spend most of their time looking for self-interest, political survival. They have not been able to put the interests of the nation before anything else. Everything has very much more to do with vested interest of the groups, of the political parties, and so on, but not the interests of the country. So this is something that Thailand needs to overcome its internal difficulties. It has to be able to gain the domestic stability. Without that, Thailand will continue to go down the road of uncertainty and will be overlooked and forgotten by the international community, while Vietnam will leap and bound into a positive and prosperous future. So it's about time that all the players in the Thai society take stock of itself, compare Thailand's position with other countries, and work for the benefit of the country as a whole. Thank you very much. ขอบคุณมากครับ